Hello, Team Iceland. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jeannie, and this is the best place to be if you are planning a trip to Iceland. Now, in today's video, I want to talk about Vík, which is a tiny village located in South Iceland. You may have heard of it because it's one of the most common places to stop and stay overnight during a trip. But what you might not know are the specifics in and around Vík that you're going to need to know in order to make your trip the best trip ever. I'm talking things like where you should eat, where you should stay, Jeannie's gems, all along with, of course, the main sights. I think it's so important to know all of these pieces and how they fit together in the bigger picture of your itinerary. Because for example, when I'm doing an itinerary review for one of my clients, a lot of times I'll see these pieces missing and I don't want you to miss a thing when you're on your trip. That's why it's so important to have access to this information. And today's video is gonna dive right into all of this. But before we get to the good stuff, make sure to subscribe to my channel because every single week I put out a new Iceland planning video and I want you to have the best information so that you can feel confident about your itinerary. Let's get into it. The first thing you need to know are the main sights around Vík. I'll start with the most famous, which is Reynisfjara, the Black Sand Beach. I would say that almost every single tourist that's coming to Iceland wants to visit this location. With good reason, you should. It's beautiful, it's so unique, and it has some amazing photo opportunities. Not far down the road is called Dyrhólé, and this is a rock arch that protrudes into the ocean. And not only that, there's two amazing things right there with it, which are the big lighthouse, which is super beautiful, and the view down either side of the Black Sand Beach. So from Dyrhólé, you're actually looking towards Reynisfjara on one side and towards the other, that beautiful coastline view that everyone loves. So after hitting those sights, just 15 minutes driving down the road, you will land in the beautiful village of Vík. When you drive into Vík, it's impossible not to see the church sitting at the top of the hill. And this is something that a lot of people want to get a photo of. So if you've seen that classic panorama with the church and the black sand beach and the basalt columns and all of the homes, this is where that happens. So all you have to do is drive up the hill and you can get that beautiful photo. Now, usually at this time, people have planned their itinerary where this is gonna be where they're going to stay for the night. But that doesn't mean that's where the exploring has to end. This is where Jeannie's Gems comes in, which is, by the way, my favorite part of perfecting anyone's itinerary. So a couple of really cool ideas for you. Number one, there is a Katla museum. It includes some information about the nearby volcano called Katla, a small exhibition, photos, all of that kind of stuff, and also has a really cute gift shop attached to it. And it's free. So it's such a good opportunity to learn a little bit about Iceland and also spend 30 minutes to an hour. Another one of my gems is the hidden black sand beach. So what does that mean? That means that there is a second black sand beach on the other side of the basalt column. Not a lot of people go there. So if you want a black sand beach to yourself, there you go. Vík also has a few different options for shopping, including icewear apparel, some little souvenir shops in their downtown walking area. All in all, I just highly recommend just walk around, do some window shopping, stretch your legs, and enjoy the scenery. So now I'm curious, up to this point, which of these places is making you the most excited about your trip? Leave a comment below and let me know. So after a day filled with exploring, you are gonna be hungry. So I have to be honest, for being the biggest village in the south, there are not a ton of different options for places to eat, but I'm gonna tell you my absolute favorite place. It's called Suðurvík, and it's located in an old home. If you think about charming, antique, creaky wooden stairs, and delicious food, that's Suðurvík. They have one of our favorite classic Icelandic meals, which is cheese pizza with jam. That's right, I said it. You put jam on top of your pizza and it's delicious. I know it sounds weird. You're like, why would you put jam on pizza? Trust me, We do not travel through South Iceland without stopping here and having that pizza. We just don't. If you try it, leave a comment below and let me know what you thought. And the last thing that you'll need to do is unwind with a good night's sleep. And for this, I highly recommend Hotel Kria. This is a beautiful, newer hotel that sits right on the main road. Therefore, you have a great view towards the ocean with a mountain behind you. What I love about Hotel Kria is they have everything there that you would need. Their staff is warm and welcoming. They'll wake you up with a Northern Lights call if they see the aurora outside. There's an awesome bar with a really good happy hour deal, cozy seating all around the hotel, a beautiful restaurant, an incredible breakfast buffet. We were recently guests at Hotel Kria, and I can confidently say that I will be returning there, and I can highly recommend it to any of you as well. All right, friends, if you found the tips in this video helpful, you are absolutely going to love my Ring Road ebook and map. In here, I literally have all of the stops lined up along the way, including how long it's going to take at each stop, where are the toilets, restaurants, Jeannie's Gems, and so much more. Whether you just started planning your trip or you're leaving next week, you're going to want to grab a copy. And I'll leave a link in the description below so you can grab it. Thanks so much for hanging out with me today, friends. Make sure to check out these videos if you need more information on how to plan your itinerary. And make sure to like this video and subscribe below so that you don't miss any future information. See you next week for another Iceland video, but until then, happy planning.